It is a crystal clear evidence that globalization reached the law even in some fields that were considered the last bastions of sovereignty, as constitutional texts or administrative law. That movement is not only a result of the increased interactions between states, but above all, the interactions between private companies and individuals in what can now be called transnational or global law. It is also clear, and Europe is the perfect laboratory, that legal sources have become more and more international, representing a significant percentage of all the legislation binding in a given jurisdiction. Before these evidences, law schools need to act. In most cases, the schools are still designed and prepared to provide legal education to the world experts based on a purely parochial approach, maybe with a glimpse of international law. At Catholic in Lisbon, we have soon realized that the world changed and that traditional legal education was no longer enough to equip our students to the global legal market. Law schools, based on the set idea of law and sovereignty, have been slow and reactive, responding to the demands of globalization. In some cases, the response was skeptical, incorporating mild elements of transnationalization in the curricula, or even in opening satellite campuses abroad to attempt geographical, though not necessarily substantial, transnationalization. The response to these challenges held to be, in my opinion, and that is what we have implemented at Catholic in Lisbon, the incorporation of the global law spirit in every area of a law school activity. It means, of course, internationalizing the faculty by hiring international professors and by promoting the international experiences of our own faculty, by improving the cosmopolitanism on campus, enhancing the presence of international students and hiring international staff. It also means that the school curriculum is designed from the bottom in a transnational mood, incorporating global elements in every course. It finally means that our ultimate goal is to prepare our students for the global market, thus providing them with the necessary tools to work successfully in it. It means training both the soft skills and the substantial knowledge that allows them to understand different legal cultures, to be able to build consistent reasoning and arguments in the most diverse contexts. Legal education in Europe is known to be, in general, somehow parochial and conservative. That might help explaining the sluggish movement towards global legal education. Fortunately, a small but vibrant group of schools has evolved by developing great quality LLMs. That is the case of Católica in Lisbon, whose LLMs were listed in the prestigious Financial Times restrictive group of most innovative world law schools. Católica also launched the Católica Global School of Law, whose main goal is to enhance legal studies in the global law and to truly embrace the global law spirit.